Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Margaux, I'm French and I live in Denmark. And today I want to share with you the top 5 things that I love about living in Denmark. So let's jump right into it. Number one is about safety. I love the fact that Denmark is a very safe country. Yeah, they have a very low crime rate here, and that's something that is very important to me. Having grown in another country that was not as safe as here, I just love the fact that I've never ever felt in danger in Denmark. Especially since I've become a mother as well, to me it's even more important. It's not just about my safety, it's the safety of my son, and I have absolutely no worries about safety at any time of the day. I can also share another part that's related to safety in a way. It's about the fact that people are quite trusting to one another. For example, if you walk by a house, it happens regularly that they have items in front of the house. They either want you to just give them for free, then no problem there, but sometimes they do have price tags on them, and you're supposed to take the item, knock at the door and pay that person, which is mind-blowing to me. I've never ever experienced that in France. Nobody would leave their objects in front of the house without someone being there, you know, to keep an eye on it. Otherwise, there's high chances that something will get stolen. So that's something that I've noticed quite a few times here, and it's pretty common. And the other thing is about the fact that you can go in a supermarket, in a playground, you can leave your bag or stroller and go like a bit far away from it, and like people leave their stuff like that, you know. And that's also something that's pretty mind-blowing to me. Coming from France, you don't leave your bag unattended, otherwise again it might get stolen from you. And here you don't have to be that worried about it. Of course you should still keep an eye on it, but it's not like if you turn for 1 second someone will grab your bag and run, you know. So my boyfriend keeps reminding me about that point regularly, because I always cling to my bag and he says, come on, we're not in France, relax. So that's the number one thing I love about Denmark. Number two is about education. I love the education system here. It's one of the best in the world. It's not the fact that it's free of charge, it's about the style of education and how the relationship between the teachers and the students. That's something that I love here. It's not about me, I will not go to school anymore. I'm done with that, but it's about my son. I'm so happy that he gets to have the education here. He's only 2 years old. He will start Vugustu very, very soon, which is before kindergarten. It's this type of nursery. Between 6 and 16 years of age, they have 1 hour per week of empathy lesson. It's called Klassen Still, and they actually talk with the teachers and with the other students, and they talk about their problems and they try to solve them together. It's just a moment that they share, and if they have no problems whatsoever, life is great, then they just have a Hygge time, which is a cozy time. And that's, again, that's something that I think is amazing. I've never ever heard about that before, and I think it's something that they have implemented quite a few years ago, and it's something that is very, very positive. 60% of the class tasks are in teamwork, and that's something also that's it's a very big percentage. Again, comparing from where I grew up, where I went to school in France, it's extremely different. What I love about education is that it's not just about passive listening, you know, it's about interacting, it's about problem solving. You can have a debate with your teacher, you can, you know, you don't have this hierarchy, like the teacher is always right kind of thing. So that's also a big plus about the education. And you are not taught to be better than everybody else, you are taught to have the opportunity to help others. And again, that's something that I think is a very big plus about the education. So they pretty much teach you empathy, they teach you to help each other out, they teach you teamwork. They teach you problem solving instead of just listening to a teacher for 3 hours straight, you know? Number three, it's about people. It's about the friendliness, the open-mindedness, and the mindset of Danish people. I have talked about it in several previous videos. So let's, I will keep it short this time. I'm just gonna say that people are very open-minded. They're very curious. You can start a conversation with somebody in the street, you know, you make eye contact, you smile at each other, and you can start a conversation. No judgment whatsoever. They are very friendly, nice, open-minded, and curious. And I think that's also something that's very positive. And wherever you go, whether you're again in like in the middle of Copenhagen or you're, you know, somewhere else in Denmark, the mindset is like that in general. So that's something that I love about Denmark. Number four is about the fact that it's environmental friendly. I love that about Denmark. They are conscious about the world, about the impact on the world, sustainability and all that. And they have this, you know, great systems put into place for renewable energy, water management, waste recycling, green transportation. They really want you to go cycling if you can. It's just the mindset in general is great, and people here follow that as well. You don't have people not doing the recycling, for example. Everybody recycles. That's something that still is not happening in France today. In my own family and friends, I see a lot of people that do not recycle anything. So that's something that I had to adapt to, and I was very happy to do that. It was about time. Don't think just about themselves. They think community oriented. Then think about the world's well-being also, not just about Denmark. And the fifth and last point that I love about Denmark, and again, that was the top five things. I love so many more things about Denmark. I will share other points in other videos. The number five things, it's about the culture. It's about Hygge. Please check out my first video I've ever posted about Hygge, and you will know a bit more about it if you're not familiar with the name itself. It's about Hygge, so Hygge technically does not have a direct translation for it, but what it means is about coziness. It's about sharing with your loved ones or by yourself, enjoying the simple pleasures of life. That's what it means, and it's about coziness and comfort. And I love the Hygge, I love the culture, I love the work-life balance. The fact that, you know, if your kids go to this very young kids school, which is the nursery, before kindergarten, usually the kids are already picked up at 3:30. Usually there's no more kids there in the afternoon. And that's something, again, I'm not familiar with, because in France, kids stay in that school for a long time because people are off work at 7, something like that, in the evening. And here it's not the same at all. Usually people by 5, they are already out, they have already picked up their kids, they're home, they're studying dinner time and all that. So that's something that I love about Denmark. I love the culture, I love the Hygge lifestyle, I love the work-life balance, that they are very productive, but they keep their work hours in that specific time frame, and they make their personal life just as important. So that's the five things I love about Denmark. I hope you liked that video. Please, if you do, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe, and please hit the notification bell so you are aware next time I post a video. And please let me know, what did you think about that video? Do you agree with that? And do you know Denmark? Are you Danish yourself, or are you a foreigner? Do you think those points are definitely very good and positive? Anything you would like to share, please leave it in comments below. I would love to hear your feedback. And yeah, that's about it for today. So have a good day, and see you next week for another video. Bye!